I'm TJ Manotok. This is your TFC News Now.
We begin with Memorial Day commemorations across the United States. U.S. President Joe Biden will join the services at the Arlington National Cemetery in Virginia. Military personnel had placed small flags near the headstones of fallen troops at Arlington ahead of the commemoration. Biden at the West Point Military Academy graduation over the weekend paid tribute to U.S. servicemen who work round the clock to support Ukraine against Russian invasion. But he reiterated his commitment against sending American boots on the front lines. Former U.S. President Barack Obama, meanwhile, surprised volunteers at a memorial flag-laying event at the Alexandria National Cemetery. Photos showed the erstwhile U.S. leader paying his respects to fallen soldiers. Obama then took photos with relatives of the fallen who were at the event. Now to the southern U.S., where a string of storms leaves several fatalities. Search and rescue operations were underway for storm victims in four states, namely Texas, Arkansas, Oklahoma, and Kentucky. Texas Governor Greg Abbott says over 100 counties in his state are under disaster declaration. In Texas alone, more than 200 buildings were destroyed and up to 38,000 people were left without power. One local recalls it was the worst she's ever seen.
We started hearing the sirens. That's when we, you know, and we had TV, but about the time the sirens went off, we lost all power and we just had to go with the sirens at that point. And that's what we did. We hid in the closets and waited for the sound to stop. When they say it roars, it roars. It was terrifying.
Forecasters have warned of more severe weather as the U.S. braces for a potentially catastrophic Atlantic hurricane season this June. And finally, on the lighter side of news, Filipino-Canadian Joe Tulliao receives a nomination equal to the Oscars in British Columbia. This was for his choreography of a scene in the 2023 film Joyride. Tulliao recalls he was speechless when he learned of the news, which made him the first Fil-Canadian to be nominated to the Leo Awards.
I get a message from my agent saying, congratulations. I was like, congratulations on what? And I look at my phone, she's like, you're nominated for two Leo Awards. And I don't know, like I'm still processing it to this day.
Tulliao's parents, Rod and Rose, say they are proud of their son's achievements. The winners of the Leo Awards will be announced during the awards night in July.
And those are the top stories making the headlines in the North American region. You can catch more of our TFC News on our website, news.abs-cbn.com/TFC News. Log on to the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel and download the ABS-CBN News app for your smartphones and tablets. I'm TJ Manotok. Stay with us, Kapamilya.